Howdy there, fellow shankers. Today, the top shankers are back. But this time, Sam, or me, is going to be teaching you how to break 80. Today, we find ourselves on the outskirts of London. Clint, activate binocular vision. This is the beautiful and challenging Par 71 Cheshunt Golf Club. Today, I'm going to be showing you tips and tricks that have helped me learn how to break 80. This philosophy is going to teach you how to save shots through course management, psychological strategy, and expectation management, all while watching how I navigate 18 holes. Let's take a look at the first hole. So today, we're going to be playing off the yellow tees. We're starting with a 549-yard par 5. As you can see, there's trouble and out of bounds all the way up the right-hand side here, but on the left, it's pretty safe. I'm going to take a driver out and try to keep my ball away from trouble down the left-hand side. It's my first shot of the day, I might be rusty, and I want to give myself an opportunity to make a good score. Remember folks, the key to scoring early on is to keep yourself in play. It might have been left, and it might not be a very good strike, but because I've avoided the danger, I'm safely in play down the other side of the fairway. Now with about 250 yards out, all I have to do is take a 6-iron to it and it should leave me a pitch on.
Perfect. Yeah, take a bounce right, it should be alright.
Right. Quite used to the greens there. Very good. Very good.
And there you have it, Shankers. A pretty easy par on what could be a tricky hole, all because of my choice of tee shot. Nice. So guys, on to hole 2, we've got a par 4, about 320 yards off the yellow tees today. I'm planning just to lay one back here with a 7-iron, try to leave myself 120 yards, which is a yardage I like, making sure I aim enough left, because there are winds left or right here.
Yeah, give you a nice angle.
Fluffed it though.
Yeah, completely fluffed that, guys. So much for the 120 yards in. Because I played safe and took the danger out of play, I'm still on the fairway, got about 170 yards out here. I've got a 9-iron. I couldn't feel it much here, but I knew from off the tee that there was a lot of wind left to right, so aiming left again.
Yeah, nice.
I started that so far left.
Good. Yeah, I would normally tip this from the rough, guys, but it's actually a really bad lie in a bubble, so I feel like the safe play is to get a putter to it just to make sure and ensure my contact and see if I can get it anywhere down there to let myself get a par.
Not bad from there.
Yeah, pretty good. Yeah. Yeah, well and Sam. Solid as a
rock. Hole 3, we're playing straight back into the teeth of the wind. And let me tell you, it's about 210 today, off the yellow tees right beside the whites. Probably playing about 230, 240 to be honest. Just trying to keep it down into the wind here, punching a 2-iron, hopefully get it somewhere around the green.
It's a bullet. That's going to be the worst bounce I've ever seen in my entire life.
Yeah, you're very unlucky. I
haven't got much of a shot, so I'm going to have to take my medicine beer and just dump. Took me a second to click on that one. That was good. Yeah, I'm going to have to just bump and run this. See if I can get it anywhere onto the green. Try to get myself two putt.
It will be quite easy to try the hero shot here, but the smart play is to realise a mistake's been made off the tee and put yourself anywhere on the green. Maybe you'll make a par, but you'll probably make a bogey.
Zimmer. Yep, nice, mate.
It's not bad from there.
Yep, same flag. Playing up hill now. Yeah, well done, Tom.
I love this next hole. Par 4, 350 yards. There's a massive tree down the middle of the fairway that you can see there, sitting 276 yards away, that kind of impedes your way into the green. So my plan was to hit one down there at about 210 yards and just lay myself back to give me a wedge over the tree to the green. We're a bit downwind, so I've got 8 iron. Absolutely melted that. Unfortunately, it went way left.
Not my best there, folks.
You can see me here where I ended up, behind a tree, examining if the hero shot is on. The hero shot is very rarely on, folks. I think I'm just going to lay myself back into the fairway and let my short game do the talking. Remember, folks, rely on your short game. The short game is the king of saving shots.
Yeah, well executed.
A little chip out sideways left me 106 in.
Get up, get up. Oh, expecting that big bounce that I got in the last couple of holes, but not today. I've got it nowhere near there, folks. Rubbish.
So I reached a point here in the round, Shankers, where I was thinking, there's no chance I'm going to break 80. I've got this for a bogey, and at best I'm going to get a double here. But Shankers, never ever give up on the golf course. Keep going. The next shot's all that matters. Keep going. Never know when something special is about to happen.
The great putt, mate. You deserved that.
As inspirational as that may be, the next hole we have here is the longest, most difficult hole in the course. It's playing 440 today, straight into the wind. So it's honestly probably closer to 500 yards. It's going to take two class shots to get it to the green here. There's also water on the left. No go. One thing that you have to remember into a strong wind is the harder you swing at the ball, the more spinny the shot's going to be, and it could lead it to be more astray. So I'm just swinging easy at a driver here, trying to keep it low.
That's pretty good into the wind, actually. Nice low one.
Yeah, nice.
Left myself a 7 iron from about 180 here. Pretty decent, just to the right hand side of the green.
Pretty decent. Straight up the hill, got a bit of left or right. So if I can get this in for a par, this would be a nice one to make on a hard hole.
One thing I did notice about this course is it had a really hard two-hole stretch with 5 and 6. It's another really difficult hole, playing about 415, dog leg to the left. You have to hit a really good tee shot here to leave yourself, again, a difficult hard shot into the green. The nature of the dogleg forces you to lay up. I've got 6 iron here and I'm trying to hit it around about 210 yards. As you can see, I was delighted with this shot.
Yep.
Mm. Yeah, sorry about that, folks. I'm not really sure what got into me there, but it's left me 200 yards out. I've got a 7-iron here, and I really want to make this count. So the only swing thought in my entire mind is make sure I commit to the shot. Commit to it, Sam.
Yeah, it looks good. Nice. Just the side of the green. That was a really good shot. Oh, Sam.
Fucking hell.
Another one.
Oh, lucky man. There, that's two in a row, Callum.
Guys, if I want to break 80, I need to get off this bogey train. But where better to start than this 143-yarder? It's guarded by bunkers at the front. My thoughts at the minute are I'm going to play a wedge, just let it float left to right in the wind.
That wind?
Not actually a bad shot, but can you believe I fluffed the chip? Of course I fluffed the chip. Just giving myself a little pep talk here. Just had one of those days where the putts were just not dropping. But you never know when it's going to turn around. In golf, you just need to stay steady, keep focused, and keep going, Shankers. Off to the 8th hole here, and after that bogey, we are now 5 over par. We got 370 yards here. I'm going to take a 5-iron off the tee, try to hit it before that bunker on the left, and just leave me a wedge in. You just need to keep going, guys. We just need to keep going. 80 is not out of our sights yet. Ah. 150 yards, left myself a wedge here.
The wind should come. Almost.
Really redemption.
Nice game, mate. Good par. Solid as
a rock. And just like that, we're back in the par train, baby. 9th hole, another long par 4 here. We got 413 yards all the way up the hill into the wind. There's trouble on the right hand side, out of bounds there, so I'm just going to aim up the left with the driver and hit it lightly again into the wind so I don't have too much spin on it. See if I can leave myself a tasty little shot in.
That wind.
Ah, that is not left. I've pushed it, I've not committed.
Just underneath that tree, I think. That first tree. Yeah. You did not catch that particularly well.
Found myself in the trees here. I'm gonna have to take a 9-iron just to get myself back out.
I'm still in play. I think it was the right play there. Get a 16, flop it over.
So this is me for bogey, folks, to go 6 over through 9 holes. Not exactly breaking 80. I need 8 over par today to break 80 and get 79. I'm not on at the minute, but I give myself a talking to at the 9th hole, and the rest of the round, I'm just going to focus on committing as much as I can to every shot. That includes trusting the line of those short putts that I've been missing a lot of. This par 4 is about 440 yards today, and it's very tight, so I'm just going to hit a 5-iron down there, it's downwind, and see if I can get myself a wedge in. Absolutely piped this with a massive downwind bounce.
Balls in that bunker. Yeah, that's left.
Only left with a short wedge in here, but I've got unlucky. It's sitting down, a wee bit of a divot. Let's see what I can do.
Better right.
Get like a number.
Bunker, you're fine.
Oh, I nearly got over the bunker. That was left, though. I think you'd. Great shot.
Oh, yeah, baby. Yeah, baby. Yeah, baby. Yeah, nicely done, mate. Yeah. Woo!
Really chuffed to get up and down out of that bunker there. Next up, we've got a 170-yard par 3. In pulling the ball left to right, I've got a 9-iron here. Just a bit fat there. I've left myself short of everything though, so it's safe. When playing delicate little chip shots like this, I have one swing thought. Commit to the chip, commit to the follow through, and never decelerate.
I just rolled off. It was a pretty good chip.
Decent, yeah, very decent.
All I'm thinking of here is commit to the line and hit it hard and true. We don't want to miss another one of these.
Yes, great up and down.
Two pars in a row and I'm starting to feel a bit more confident. And what's next makes me feel even better. 470 yard par 5. Short par 5 for me. This is when I know that I can strike. Anything left is out of play. Right looks pretty safe. I'm going to aim down the right hand side and just put a driver down there.
Flop shot.
As you can tell, that was a terrible strike, but because I was aiming away from the danger, I'm still safe and in this hole.
Damn, I flopped under that, but I got so away with it. Just right in the path.
Bad drive, but I'm still leaving myself a chance. I've got 200 yards here. This feels like the opportunity I needed to bring my score down. When you've got a good chance, don't get overexcited, stay steady and remember the basics. Keep that head still and commit. And that, my friends, gives me an eagle putt, baby.
Drop, mate. Just get this pitch mark sword.
Let's just focus on this one, spit left or right. And just commit to the putt. Commit to the stroke. You got this.
It
was in all the way. I can't never leave an eagle putt short, folks.
Yeah.
Good chance at bird, though.
Take the birdie.
Always take the birdie.
And just like that, we stuck with it and we're back in the race for Rudy. This par 4 is only 314 yards, but it's into a massive gale of wind here. So I'm going to take a 7-iron off the tee and just try to lay myself somewhere that I can keep it safe and see what I can get going into the green. I really just want to keep this straight after that birdie.
Yeah. Yeah.
This is another 7-iron. Hit both of these balls seriously high, and they hardly went anywhere, to be honest. God, cheer up, Sam.
Oh yeah.
Stop. Great shot, mate.
Take that. Any day of the week, baby.
Yeah, nice par, Sam. Solid
as a rock. I'm happy with that.
Smooth operator.
On to this next hole then. We're still 5 over par through 13 holes. So this is 350 yard par 4. Right's trouble, left is actually okay, even though there's still trees there. We're still into this strong wind, so I'm just going to take a 2-iron here and see if I can leave myself a pitching wedge or something in. Bit of a moon ball, but I'll take anything on the fairway into that wind. I think this is my first course management mistake of the round, guys. There's people behind us, I rushed a little bit, and I didn't actually take into account the wind that was kind of coming diagonally right to left into us, and I did not aim far enough right.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, pretty good, mate.
Oh, Whoa! That thought I was in all the way.
Great effort, mate.
Boog!
The boogeyman.
The boogeyman bites the dust.
Okay, folks, on to hole 15, and this is as tight as it looks. It's 370 yards from the tees we're playing today. There's a burn up there at about 275 yards. My idea here, with the wind slightly helping off the left, is to play a 5-iron down just before the burn and leave myself 100 yards on.
Yeah.
This was one of my best strikes of the round. I just got absolutely everything behind it.
Demo.
About 110 left here, and I just want to commit to the shot and make sure I get it on the green.
Yeah, be the distance. Yeah, roll.
This, folks, is my second course management faux pas of the round. I'm now playing well, stringing some shots together, and I really am excited about getting a birdie here. I should lag this up for a par, but no, 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 Sammy. You're going to go for it, aren't you?
Wow.
Always back off a putt if you're not feeling comfortable.
I hurt myself today.
Sammy.
I won't lie, that three putt really hurt. But it was my fault. Lucky I should have been thinking more clearly. Calabash. Onwards and upwards, folks. On to the next hole.
You know how heartbreaking that is?
Yeah.
I said it once, I said it a million times. You have to only focus on the next shot. So as we approach this 367-yard par 4, and erase that last bad shot and think about how I'm going to get myself in play here. As you can see, there's trouble all along the left and right-hand side, and there's a burn up there at I think around about 250 yards. So I'm downwind here, and I'm actually going to take a 7-iron and see if I can lay myself back and leave myself a pitching wedge in.
Tracker. Yeah, money.
Christ, I'm still looking seriously deflated after that three putt. 140 yards left here. It's really downwind. I don't know if you've seen the movie Goal, but in that movie, Santiago Nunez learns that you have to let the ball do the work. And here, that's what I'm trying to do. I'm just trying to let the ball do the work and roll it up onto the green.
Great distance control.
Oh, a three putt that one.
Just want a bit of that Macintosh special sauce.
His putting was crazy.
This is a serving. Putts today on the bloody platter.
Sam, do you want to use my putter?
A birdie here would be fantastic. Come on, boys. Come on.
Oh, he's tracking. I'll take that last one long. I think I just, I'll take it.
Okay, folks, we've made it this far. Only two holes to bring it home. We've got a nice little 82 yarder here. All I'm trying to do is hit the 60 degree, just float it down there. There's a bit of left to right breeze. Let's go.
That's towards the back of the green. Oh no, great. Yeah, good weight as well.
And from almost out of nowhere, guys, I actually have this putt to return to 6 over par, where I was after 9 holes. And that's the beauty of golf. Anything can happen.
Oh! Oh!
Inches, mate. Inches.
Honestly, I thought that was in, guys. I thought it was in.
What a big putt.
That is close, but I'll take the par from there.
Take the par every day.
Absolutely, mate. Great effort.
Today, this hole's playing at 520, all the way up the hill. It's straight into the wind, so it's probably playing 600 yards, definitely a three-shot par 5. I'm taking a driver, getting it down there somewhere safe. We've made it to the last hole here. I really hope you've enjoyed the video. I've enjoyed making it for you guys. You're the reason we do this, and we're just out here trying to live the dream. So if you could, make sure you try and subscribe, share the video, and drop it a like. And remember everything I've taught you today, guys. The most important thing about golf or any sport is never to give up. Commit till the last shot. You never know what is around the next corner. Let's see if we can get the job done.
Done right, but that'll just be on the next fairway. Yeah, next.
Okay guys, I've hit a bad drive there, but it's safe. I've got a 7-iron here and I'm just trying to put this back in play and leave myself a shot into the green.
Yeah, cracker.
Got 100 yards here.
Go.
Just floated it up a bit too much into the wind.
Oh, the
bit
wind
short.
Absolutely floated that. He's a windy boy. That was crazy.
This is a hard last hole.
It's my last putt, and I know how close I am to breaking 80. I know all I have to do is lag it up to the hole, but I don't want to be tentative about it. I want to stay committed to my stroke and make sure I get it there. Focus. Keep your head still.
Get right.
This is it, folks. All those missed putts earlier in the round suddenly seem like a distant memory. This is me, to break 80.
Come on, baby.
Good par to finish.
Yeah, mate. Stop right, Jack. You're really good.
And that, folks, was how to break 80.